السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام
يوتسفول.
ورحمة الله وبركاته.
If I say السلام عليكم, you have to say a little more. وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله
وبركاته.
No, ورحمة الله يمكن.
Okay.
If I say السلام عليكم ورحمة الله, you have to say وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. Correct like that. So today's topic is lesson number 11. Okay. The topic is about நம்முடைய உறக்கம்.
Sleep. Our sleep.
So you know what is it?
Yes.
Nammude orakkam means our sleep. See, the manas is also there for sleeping also.
Yeah.
Right. That's why I said in the last class. This manas in all Islam, manas will be there in all aspect of Islam.
Yes.
Not just eating or just no. It will be all aspect will be covered. So I think this is the last chapter, I think last lesson from this akhlaq topic. Maybe we'll go to next book next week. Okay, so this week we'll finish with this. Okay, maybe we'll have some test. So nammude urakkam, it's about sleep. Urakkamillatha ഒരു വസ്തുവെ പറ്റി നിങ്ങൾ ആലോചിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ടോ? ഡിഡ് യു ഹാവ് എ ഹേർഡ് അബൌട്ട് എനി ലിവിംഗ് ബീയിങ്സ് വിതൗട്ട് സ്ലീപ്പ്?
നോ,
ഐ ഡോണ്ട് തിങ്ക് സോ. ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ഹാവ് മേ ബി ഇൻ പ്രിമിറ്റീവ് ലെവൽ. ഉറക്കമില്ലാത്ത ഒരു സത്യ ഒരു വസ്തുവെ പറ്റി നിങ്ങൾ ആലോചിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ടോ? സോ ഡിഡ് യു സീ എനി ഡിഡ് യു കം അക്രോസ് എനി ലിവിംഗ് ബീയിങ്സ് വെയർ they did not sleep or they don't sleep? No, they all sleep.
Yeah.
Almost whatever we know, they all sleep. Yatra bhigaramayirikkum adu. So how horrible it will be that there is a living being. Mainly we are concerned about human beings here. If the people is not able to sleep. You understand? Yeah. Sleeping is human beings means they will sleep. But the here topic is how the amount of sleep. Okay, your sleep means you not sleep too much also or too less also. We should have a balance. That's the manas.
Yes.
Islam talks about that. Islam doesn't talk about that. Oh, no sleep and just pray all the time. No. We are not talking about that. That is haram. In fact, that is because that will affect your health.
Yeah.
You're basically killing your health like that. Or not just related to Islam. Anything that you do more continuously without any sleep, anything, even that should be a very good thing also in the world. It's not allowed because we have.
What about
Laylatul Qadr night also we will be sleeping. It's not that we will be sleeping for some time, then we'll be getting up again. We'll sleep sometime, something like that. There will be a balance in that. Understand? It's not that we do that Laylatul Qadr for throughout the year, right? It's just 10 days of a last 10 days of the Ramadan, right? There also there is a balance in sleep, is there? It's not that, right?
Yeah.
We forgot the pattern of sleeping. The way Laylatul Qadr, that is the correct pattern of sleep, because our body is like that. But nowadays people are told to sleep continuously. 8 hours sleep continuously.
It's good.
Actually, that is not the
cut. We should only take naps.
No, we should sleep not 8 hours continuously. Actually, our thing is that there is our body is certain. We are a biological living organism.
Yeah.
And Allah is the best one to tell what is the best way to sleep. And Prophet is the one who gives the guidelines.
Yeah.
So he told that you should sleep, but when you reach the last 1/3 of the night, you should get up and do prayer, zikr and all.
I wake up.
Ah, that, but you wake up only for Fajr, but I think just before Fajr. There where you have to do zikr, because that is the very important time in the night.
But I have online school, so I have school.
Oh. No, now it's okay, you are growing only, but after some time, once you reach a certain age, you can do that also, okay? So, not continuously, we have to sleep, but last 1/3 of night we should get up. Nowadays the practice is that we are sleeping very late. Because of that we are not able to get up for 1/3 of the night. లాస్ట్ వన్ తర్వాత నైట్. బట్ ఇఫ్ యూ యాక్చువల్ అవర్ సున్నా ఇస్ టు స్లీప్ జస్ట్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఎషా ఆర్ లిటిల్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఎషా మేబీ. ఓకే మేబీ కెన్ టేక్ బ్రేక్ఫాస్ట్ బిఫోర్ దట్ ఆర్ జస్ట్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఎషా కెన్ టేక్ ఇట్ అండ్ దెన్ డోంట్ డ్రాగ్ ఇట్ టిల్ లేట్ నైట్ టు స్లీప్. జస్ట్ టేక్స్ ఫర్ సమ్ టైమ్ డూ యువర్ ఆల్ యువర్ వర్క్స్ ఫర్ నెక్స్ట్ డే ప్లాన్ ఇట్ షెడ్యూలింగ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ దెన్ స్లీప్. That's what we do, no? We sleep by 9, 9.30, everyone go to bed, right?
Mm.
Correct. So, it should not be too late, like 11, 12 o'clock and all. Then it's very difficult to get up. The pattern is, our Prophet said that, we should sleep after Isha. Just little after Isha, you can just, don't sit too much after Isha.
Mm.
Okay? And sleep. Okay. Then so that you can get up for midnight.
Okay.
Midnight means, I mean, the last one third night. That's the actual, what Prophet said, no, is the correct model. We forgot that sunnah and now we think that our continuous 8 hours sleep. No. That's the modern way of thinking it. Our Prophet is also a big doctor or, you know, big scientist in a different way. So when he says something, no, that's the best model. Okay? So here we are saying, can you imagine a living being without a sleep? That's a horrible thing. Adupole orangyal Unaratirinalo. If somebody slept and he is not getting up, he is continuous sleep.
Okay.
That's also bad.
That's also bad.
That means
human being needs 8 hours sleep at least.
That's the what modern scientists says. They didn't get it that through some book or something. Just through ideally what they think is 8 hours sleep. Like they arrived at that figure. Nothing like that. In Islam also, we don't see number. What is required, we have to sleep, but too much is not good. Okay? Too much less is also problem, too much also. Okay? Aduvale orangyal unrathirikkum. So that means if you sleep and if you don't get up, that's also bad. Or if you don't sleep at all, that's also bad. So where is the balance now? Urakkam unarchayum Allahu namakku nalgiya mahattaya rendu anugrahamangala. You know? What is that? Waking up from the sleep and sleep, getting sleep is basically, you know, we don't realize it. It is basically a blessing in disguise.
Well, getting sleep.
There are some people who can't sleep also. I have seen many people, they have to take tablets to sleep. Maybe they have, I don't know, it is some physical problem or maybe they have some psychological problem or maybe they are tensed with some other issues and worries and, you know, life. There are a lot of situation where people get into some different difficult situation by which they always haunt that always haunts them, and because of they can't sleep and it will cause real health problems.
Mm.
May Allah save us from all those things, you know, because this sleep, no, one person, if he sleeps nicely, means he's in peace.
Happy.
Actually his body is in peace, he is in peace. That's a blessing, we don't realize it. This is Allah's blessing. Some people, they will always worry about that, this thing. And because of that, they can't sleep at all. They have to take tablets and all. And it's not good taking tablets for sleeping. I don't advise at all. We should sleep the way naturally, what is a natural way, you know? What Allah designed for us,
no
human.
Way to sleep, no? Go park, take at least 10 rounds and come back. You will feel so tired when you go to sleep.
That is the people who don't have any work in the world, no? For them, okay, we are all working, we go outside, we have work, you know, there's a lot of activities there, we'll go to masjid, right?
Yeah.
So automatically we get sleep by the day. The people who don't have any other work, no, they have to go around full and then to get tired, to make that body tired and then get sleep. No, we're not, actually, if you're sitting all day in the office and not do anything, then you have to do that. But people who are working in the field and mechanic and all that,
okay,
carbon, they are all moving around all day in the sun and all. Automatically by night they'll get sleep. That's a blessing. Sleep is a
blessing.
It's a blessing. We have to remember that, okay? Manasum Sharirum Uru Arugyamulatyavar Adi Atyavashaman. That means for this manas, right? That means your mind and body and that everything is required for your good health. Arogyam ulla dai tiral ava atyavashyam. It is very, very much necessary to have a, what is that, proper mind and proper body, healthy body.
Okay.
It's very much important. We take it for granted to have a good health and good mind, and that's why we get feel like
sleeping,
you feel like doing other thing. Otherwise, you get always tense, worried, and you don't feel like doing anything.
That's
mostly because of business. No, even business also, in anything, any profession, whether it's business or anything personal, you should find a balance. Okay, try to find peace so that you can live in peace and you can sleep in peace. Okay. It all happens when there is some issue unnecessarily we people create, maybe through extra anger. When problems still comes in life, but you should know how to find solution to the problem and how to find an amicable solution which is easy and nice to solve. You can solve it. Always problem comes, but Allah has given intelligence also to solve it. Minute I found out when some problem gets it, then I'll think. Suddenly next day Allah will give some solution to it and solve. And mind will be peace. So don't worry, immediately when some problem comes, we'll get tense. Oh, understand?
Yeah.
Immediately, when we get tense, then at that moment, but when you sit for some time, sit in a cool place and start thinking, you automatically get some solution to the problem. It's like that.
Actually, sometimes when you close your eyes and try sleeping, you will get the idea.
Yeah, so but don't, at that moment, you'll write, oh, what to do, why, this is so big problem. You might not get, but when you think coolly and sit in one place, Allah will give some solutions. It's always like that. Okay, I always found like that. At that moment, you'll find that, oh, nothing, there is nothing I can't see in this moment. Oh, nothing, there is no solution. No, solution will be there. It's only that at that moment, it doesn't occur in your mind because of the tense moment. Okay, so always remember that in life, when a certain situation comes, just relax. After some time, you will get solution, inshallah. എന്നാൽ അമിതമായ ഉറങ്ങുന്ന ഉറക്കൊഴിവാക്കുന്നത് നമ്മെ രോഗികളാക്കും. സോ വാട്ട് ഈവൻ ഇഫ് യു സ്ലീപ് ടു മച്ച് ദാറ്റ് ഓൾസോ വിൽ മേക്ക് യു അൺഹെൽത്തി. അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ്? ദാറ്റ് ഓൾസോ ഇറ്റ് വിൽ മേക്ക് യു അൺഹെൽത്തി. ഇറ്റ് വിൽ കോസ് പ്രോബ്ലം ഫോർ യുവർ ലൈഫ്, ഫോർ യുവർ ബോഡി. ടു മച്ച് സ്ലീപ്. That's why always I say, when you get, I say, don't sleep 9 beyond, sometimes Friday after Fajr you sleep till 9, 9:30, right? I don't like, that's not good. Don't sleep too much. Okay, 7, 7:30, 8 you can get up. It's nice to get up a little early and do all the things. Don't sleep too much. Okay? If you want to sleep, you sleep in the afternoon. Between, after lunch and between Asr, no?
Sleep in that time.
That's the sunnah. We forgot sunnah. When you forget sunnah, then we'll get into some other trouble. Sleep that time. Okay? If at all in the daytime you want to sleep during that time. Okay? So that night you will not get stressed that you have to sleep for 10 hours for that. Because in the day you slept little bit, no? So you have to balance accordingly. So we have to follow the sunnah. So do I sleep in the afternoon? Yeah, I sleep, right? Wherever possible time I get office, sometimes I can't. Maybe I'll just find out in break time, I just sleep, I take a nap. 15, half an hour now. But otherwise, your weekdays are nice sleep in the afternoon, right? Yeah. So, you should find a balance. Everything, life is all about, all angle we have to balance it. Understand? Sleep, eating, the way you dress, in all aspects, there will be a proper, rules and guidelines.
Yeah.
Understand? I just want to give one example. Long back I heard about, bank. I don't generally like all this banking thing and all because they deal in interest. But still, having said that, I saw one particular bank. They have guidelines for everything.
Ooh.
In the sense even if they want to take a small wire for something to be, they have a guidelines for that. It has to be like this. It has to be from this one. It has to be they have specification for even everything. So.
Wire for what?
I mean, not just wire. I'm just giving an example. If just you're buying a wire for fixing a computer, small thing, they will have rules for that also. They have guidelines for that also. So I was thinking, Islam is also like that. For every aspect, Islam will be there, governing us. Cutting the nails part, whether oiling our hair, taking bath Friday, the way when you go out of the home, how to put leg, which leg you have to put it, come inside, you say Bismillah, and all that, every aspect is Islam is there. All this constitutes towards worship. We think that worship is only only prayer. No. That's the highest form, of course. That is salah we do, no? But apart from that, what there are so many areas Prophet has said, okay, do this way, do this way. That is for our goodness only it is. This world. And we'll find peace actually when you do that. How much you follow, no, it's good, okay? So sleeping too much also is not good. It's unhealthy, okay? നേരത്തെ ഉറങ്ങി നേരത്തെ എഴുന്നേൽക്കുന്നവനെ എഴുന്നേൽക്കണമെന്ന് നബി സല്ലല്ലാഹു അലൈഹി വസല്ലം പഠിച്ചിരിപ്പിക്കുന്നു. നേരത്തെ ഉറങ്ങി, ദാറ്റ് മീൻസ് യു ഷുഡ് സ്ലീപ് ഏർലി. വാട്ട് ഇസ് ദ ഐഡിയൽ ടൈം ഇറ്റ് വോൾഡ്? ജസ്റ്റ് ആഫ്റ്റർ ഇഷാ, ലിറ്റിൽ ആഫ്റ്റർ ദാറ്റ്, നോട്ട് ടു മച്ച്, ലിറ്റിൽ ആഫ്റ്റർ ഇഷാ മേ ബി. വാട്ട് ഇസ് ഐഡിയൽ? 9:30, ലൈക്ക് ദാറ്റ്. നോ, വി സ്ലീപ് ലൈക്ക് ദാറ്റ്. വി ഡു ദാറ്റ്. But there are some people who sleep very late, you know, watch TV till 12 o'clock, 11, 1 o'clock. That's not good. It will affect our body on a, not an immediate level, maybe on a long-term level.
Yeah.
On a long-term level, it will affect our body.
Some people
they
stay till 4 o'clock.
Yeah, so that's not a good thing. It's not, we should sleep early. What Prophet said and did is the best model, okay? നേരത്തെ ഉറങ്ങി നേരത്തെ എഴുന്നേൽക്കുന്നു നബി സല്ലല്ലാഹു അലൈഹി വസല്ലം പഠിപ്പിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നു. സോ ഡോട്ട് സെഡ് റൈറ്റ്, യു ഷുഡ് സ്ലീപ് ഏർലി ആൻഡ് ഗെറ്റ് അപ്പ് ഏർലി. വാട്ട് ഇസ് ഗെറ്റ്? ഹൗ ഏർലി? ഇസ് ലാസ്റ്റ് 1:30 നൈറ്റ് യു ഷുഡ് ഗെറ്റ് അപ്പ്. നോട്ട് എക്സാക്ട്ലി ഫദർ വെൻ അസാൻ ഇസ് ഹാപ്പനിങ്, ജസ്റ്റ് ബിഫോർ ദർ, മേ ബി ഹാഫ് ആൻ അവർ, 1 hour ബിഫോർ ദർ, ഇഫ് പോസിബിൾ. ഓക്കെ, ഹാഫ് ആൻ അവർ ബിഫോർ ദർ, റൈറ്റ്? പപ്പ മമ്മ വിദേ ടു നോ ലൈക്ക് ദാറ്റ് യു ഷുഡ് ഫോളോ. നോട്ട് നൗ, മേ ലേറ്റ് ഇൻ ലൈഫ് യു ഷുഡ് ടു ഇറ്റ്. ഓക്കെ, നൗ ദ ഫജർ ടൈം ഇസ് ഫൈൻ ദാറ്റ്. ഓക്കെ, but I'm just telling you so that you remember that. Okay, vaigi orangugayum vaigi ezhunnelkuyum cheyunnavarku padana sheshi kurayum ennu shastram kandittum. That means there are some research they are saying that if you sleep late and you get up late, you'll have some intellectual cognitive problems will be there. In terms of ability of thinking and cognitive abilities, you know, that it will reduce this. I don't know how true it is, but it could be, you know, because we are changing the sleeping habit. Our body is very complex biological system. It is, you can say it's like a machine on a high level. So if you don't do it in a certain way, right? Even for anything, even physical hardware, machines, computers and all, if you do it in a different way, it might get spoiled. Same way, our body also is a kind of very complex machine. So it requires guidelines and procedures. Otherwise, it will create health problems, psychological problems, cognitive problems will be there, thinking problems, imagining problems, problems in so many areas, eyes, ears, you understand? It will be completely, it will create a health problems. So we should be very careful how much watch TV also. You should not watch too much TV, you should not watch too near to it, you know, all the other things and all, you can take care of that. You should take care of our body, eyes, ears and all. Okay. Urakkam oru pagudhi maranamaan. Okay, so now let's talk about little theological part of sleep. Okay, this now I just told about biological part. Let's talk about some theological part. What is actually sleep in Islam?
Oh, okay.
Urakkam oru pagudhi maranam. It's like a little, you know what is it? Urakkam pagudhi maranam. It's like a little death. Don't you think so?
No.
It's like a minor death. Sleep is like a
minor death.
What there's other sleep which is permanent death. That means you die and that's permanent. But the sleep what we get now, it's like a minor death. Why it is called minor death? Because you will be completely unconscious. You don't know that you are in the world until you wake up.
Yeah.
Then you have to say Alhamdulillah. Why you have to say Alhamdulillah when you get up? You know what happens, you know? Orangumbol Allah vilekettun ettunna atmavin Allah tirichun tannal namukku ഉണരാകുന്നയാൾ. ദിസ് ഇസ് തിയോളജിക്കൽ വാട്ട് മുസ്ലിംസ് ബിലീവ്. മേ ബി അതേഴ്സ് പീപ്പിൾ ഡോണ്ട് ബിലീവ്. വി ബിലീവ്. വാട്ട് ഇസ് ദ ബിലീവ് വി ഹാവ്? വെൻ യു സ്ലീപ് നോ, അവർ സോൾ വിൽ ബി ഗോയിങ് ടു ദ ഹെവൻ ആൻഡ് ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ഗോ ടു ദ ഹെവൻ. റൂ, ദ റൂഹ് വിൽ ഗോ ടു ദി ഹെവൻ ആൻഡ് ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ഗോ ടു അല്ലാഹ്. ഇറ്റ്സ് ജസ്റ്റ് ഇറ്റ്സ് എ how it goes, we don't know. It's unseen, ripe information. Okay, but we believe what Prophet said. So ruh goes to the heaven, and if that ruh goes and that stays with the heaven there only, and Allah don't give it back to our body, that's called death. We died. If it comes back by next day morning, if it comes back, it means we are alive. This is what we believe. So that's why I call it, it's like a minor death. Allah takes the ruh, still we will be breathing, not that. But Allah will take the ruh, and if the ruh doesn't come back the next day morning, we are dead. This is what we believe. So it's like minor death. That's why when we get up and say, oh, thank God Allah has put back my ruh back, so I'm alive. That's why we make the dua. What is the dua we make? Alhamdulillah illazi ahyana ba'da ma matan wa ilayhi nushur. Correct, no?
Yeah.
So we make that dua. You understood, no? Okay. Adila naam marnate oath mariyadagal palichu kondairikkanum kidakkanad. That means we should follow, because of that we should remember about death, that death can happen in sleep also, and we should remember that and sleep it in a nice manner. Don't sleep watching cartoon and then go to sleep. No, we should follow some Islamic, because you might die in the sleep. So you should do all the good things before sleeping. That's what mama say, no? You have to say Fatiha, Surah Fatiha, and all that thing, no? Should say and sleep. Okay? Aa orakil naam marichal namukku swargam pratikshikkam. So if at all we did some good thing and slept, no? All that Islamic thing, whatever they told to do, and you slept it, and if you die, then we can expect Jannah. Okay? Now let's talk about what are the orakatil mariyadagal, what are the manners in sleep or before sleep. One is miswak cheyuka. Do you do miswak? Means brushing.
I don't have a brushing.
Yeah, but miswak means if you have that miswak brush kind of thing, okay, that's good. If you don't have, do normal brush, no problem. Ulu edukuga, you take ulu and sleep.
Okay.
Surat ikhlas oduga. And muwazzatain enni suratukal odi kaigal oodi shariram mujvanum taduga. So you should read ikhlas, surat ikhlas, kul huwallahu, then muwazzatain, kul huwallahu falaka, kul huwallahu binnas, 3 times. You have to read, blow it on your hand and wipe it on the body 3 times.
Okay.
You should do from today onwards, okay?
Okay.
Mama always say that, but today you have to follow strictly. Then you have to say Subhanallah 33 times, Alhamdulillah 33 times, Allahu Akbar 34 times.
Yeah.
And then also you say Ayatul Kursi. You know Ayatul Kursi, right?
Yeah, I know.
So you say that, and also after that sleep.
Okay.
If possible, you can recite all the Surah Mulk also if possible. Because that will protect from the punishment of the grave.
Yeah, but I don't know it.
It will reduce the punishment, okay? I don't know. So it's a 30 ayahs then, that I think.
Okay.
Okay. Maybe in 10 minutes you can finish it. No, less than 10 minutes, yeah. Kedakumbol is e zikr chulluga. So when you sleep, when you before sleeping, you should say Bismikallah, Bismik Rabbi Allah tu jambi, wabik arfau in amsakta nafsi, farhama wa in arsalta, fafullah bima tafullah bihi bati sal. You have to buy heart this, okay? This dua. I'll make you buy heart later. This dua you have to say and sleep. You can if you can't remove this one, at least tell the other one. Bismika Allahumma amutu ahiya. Or Allah, Allahumma bismika amutu ahiya.
You can
say that at least, okay? But this also is there. Like that 2-3 are there. I'll teach you slowly. But at least you say this one by time being, okay? Unarum bol chulluga alhamdulillah alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilayhi nushur. Did I say that just now? When you get up, you have to say alhamdulillah alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilayhi nushur. Alhamdulillah alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilayhi nushur. Kiblak abhimugamai walatu bhagatek chirichani kidakku. So when you sleep, no? Sleep towards your, you know, right, you know. Okay, just you can sleep in a towards the right, facing towards the Qibla. If possible, okay? But at least don't put leg towards the Qibla. At least try to avoid that. If you can't do this one, at least try to put leg towards the Qibla when sleeping.
Leg
towards the Qibla. We don't do that. Even when you go to washroom also, no, make sure that when you washroom, when you do sitting also, don't face the Qibla, okay? Should be, or you should not face your back towards the Qibla. Front, no problem. Back, you should not face. So we should respect certain things. And when spitting on all, when you're in the road, when you're spitting, or maybe in the bath, make sure they don't spit towards the Qibla side.
Yeah.
You understand? Are you following that all that? Oh, so small things, you know, but
no, you won't spit.
No, if at all when you spitting comes, you know. Make sure that you don't face Qibla.
Yeah.
On the road also, video.
Our bathroom sinks and toilets all.
No, no, but you know, you always our mind should be a conscious of where is our Qibla at any moment in time. So when you do spitting and sleeping or going to washroom, keep that in mind, okay? And we should not sleep.
Like this with the.
What do you call this?
Face put.
Malar, this one. What do you call? Karmindu. Karmindu means. Face and full body, you know, towards the bed.
Bed.
That's not. It's basically despised by Prophet. The people who are in Jahannam, no, they sleep. They sit like that, or they lie like that. Jahannam, this is a punishment. So we don't sleep in the bed like that. Understand?
Okay, okay.
These are some of the manners we have to follow when sleeping. Allah namme swargatil torga vashigalaki pittumatte. Ameen. So we make a dua that may Allah make us in Jannah. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So inshallah we'll I think with this we have finished this topic. Maybe we'll start with a new chapter on a new different topic. We'll see in the next class. Okay. So I'll stop here. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.